we are good that you have invited us for this distinguished audience. To start with, I must say, it happened by sheer accident, not by design or not by compulsion. Just the election result has changed the lifestyle of Hagi Jawad.
That's a very short answer, we need something more than that.
Well, that's a fact. Yeah. I cannot add more to what I know of.
No, I know, but tell us how where you started and how you progressed then.
In 77, we had the general election and I was a government employee. Of course, at that time, I was with the then government decision makers. The new government came in and transferred me to Pakistan.
Okay.
I said, I'm a trader, I have started this department. We are in number one slot. I told the then minister, the late Mr. Aswad Ali, I said, I don't think that I will be able to go. He said, you have a lot of inquiries about you. So we have to investigate. I said, okay, I'll stay, but not to work under your leadership. So we started on our own. We are looking for a name. Because I was told by the then government servants who in charge of the regulations of making companies and getting the tea board approvals, this will be difficult for you. I learned a lesson from some of my colleagues and they said, we put your name. So that is how the birth of Chatan in 7th September 1977. It's surely by accident. Thereafter, I am sorry to say that company had to close down after we started 1.5 years. The company was the leader of the tea business, the produce business, practically everything we all. With me, so the entire department came. So that is how we started Chatan Exports from the day one. From the day week after, we started operating at the auctions. Of course, all the buyers who had confidence, who had seen our work being done, they joined me. First year itself, I did about 8,000 tons. I don't think any other company in the first year of operations would have done that kind of volume, having nothing in the pocket. When I went to the bank, they said, look, who are you? So when I told my buyers, they said, don't worry, we'll fund you. Send us the tea, send us the produce, all top companies. Why we built I built a name. There's a claim I made. If there's a mistake, we admit it. So in business, one has to be honest. If you try to have shortcuts and try to make a fast buck, it doesn't work. So you can learn a lesson from me, being honest, the price that I have paid and to what extent that we have been successful.
Okay. Mr. Kennedy.
I have a question because you mentioned about he wanted to become a politician. Mr. Javatar, what's your own take on politicians being funded by private sector? You think it's a necessary evil?
What is your question? I can't.
Funding politicians. What's your own take? Should private sector fund or make it very transparent?
I don't know about others. I don't like to fund any politician because they cannot be trusted. Our the central bank is here. He knows better.
Thank you. Thanks, Dinesh. On behalf of FTA, let me welcome. Though we started on a lighter way, I'd like to ask these six gentlemen, in their opinion, what is success? Because we are all here because these guys are successful, right? But I'm sure all six will have different definitions of their own success. So I want each one to briefly say, in your opinion, what do you think is success? Since you have the mic, you can start, Mr. Javatar.
what exactly you are looking at.
Yes.
I think.
How do you say, I mean, what is your measure of success?
My success or the success of all of us?
Everyone, each one.
Well, they are masters of their own field. So everybody has to be honest and do the work properly. Try to go behind tenders, try to go behind various deals. If you work hard, I mean, like me, I don't go behind deals. I don't participate in tenders. I participate in foreign tenders. Where at that time, till 77, this government, this country was a closed economy. After 77, the then president, he made it open. Foreign exchange was on quota. They allocated first for food, first for second for education, so many things, and what is remnants is only for import of other items. So that's why the smuggling trade started. From Velletri to it, all the Indian goods came. Airport, the people came and the gold was smuggled. Why this was closed? Foreign exchange was difficult. Nobody could import anything. We didn't have anything. Most of the people who travel to India, they take 7 o'clock rates at that time. Olive oil, Andrew Cleaver salt, cloves, cardamom. Why? Because they were not given exchange. They were given £3 and 10 pence, that is 50 rupees at that time. So people had to go and live from friends or relatives or whatever it is. So they took this, they started a barter trade between themselves. After selling those, because everybody who went to India at that time, adults got, I think, 18 bottles of spirits and 12 bottles of beer. And opposite the station, there Spencer's was here. He had his restaurant. They straight go there, they sell the beer and the rack, and from